you can set some of the visual aspects to the batch group, like color schemes, in the settings tab. We have categorized classic and classic anchored color schemes. I'll show you those in a few moments. You can also select when to update the batch query. The default is when display updates, similar to the ProcessBook trend. Or you can use update it only when the display loads, or not to use the query function. You can also elect whether to show new results or hidden results as time marches on. So as you get new batches start up, whether to show them or not. I'll go into ProcessBook, and I've got a batch group here. And if I want to change the color scheme for this particular batch group, I simply double click on it and I go into the settings tab. Here's where all those options are set. And you'll see the color schemes. There are three. Categorized means that the anchored batch is always yellow, the completed batches are always colored blue, and the running batches are always colored green. And the most recently completed is always marked in red. That is the standard color scheme for batch view. You can go to an anchored classic view, which has all of our traces as their classic colors, as in ProcessBook, with the anchored batch always in yellow. Or you can simply turn off all semblance of batch color scheme and go back to the PI ProcessBook classic trace colors. That's with the scheme classic. Now this will change the color scheme for this particular batch group. But if I wanted to change it for all of my batch groups for the future, I would go into Tools and Preferences and select PI BatchView. If I change the color preferences here, then or any of the configuration settings for any of my four items in my batch group, these will change these settings for the future. So every batch group that you build will have these new settings. So just remember, if you want to change your global preferences, you go to Tools and Preferences in ProcessBook and select Batch View. Batch View has the ability to use what are called custom name sets. Custom name sets are a way in which you can modify the naming conventions for each item in the batch database, and these definitions can be applied per batch group or per system or even per user. There's a couple step process involved in this. The first step is to define the naming convention in the batch custom name editor. It's a plugin to the SMT, and then we apply that in the batch view component. And here's an example where we have an oil and gas example where the batch ID is converted to a heading called blend number. The product is renamed grade, and the procedure is the season. So the headings are labeled that way, and you can see that the PI unit batches have been renamed list of blends. So you don't select from PI unit batch, you select from list of blends. And then the batch ID numbers are blend numbers. Here's an example of a pulp and paper example where the batch ID is the jumbo number and the unit batches are jumbos. So you can see that they're searching for list of jumbos. And this naming convention affects all the labels that the users see. So, you can set these options by enabling or disabling this using this custom name settings executable. It's in the program files PyPC batch folder, and you could even set a default for this computer if you wanted to change the default naming convention. Let's look at a really quick example of this. I'm going to go into batch custom names, and let's say I want to create a custom name set here for my paper mill, and I'm just going to call this custom name set paper mill. And without getting too detailed here, let's call the batch ID number, Baskin's lot number, and then the unit batches would then be lot numbers. And I'll save that, and then I'll go into my ProcessBook display, and I'll create a new batch group really quickly. And let's say I want to search my digester. So I'll do a quick digester search, and you can see that I have batch ID is what I'm searching on. Now if I go into settings and I change the custom name set to paper mill, you'll notice that when I go back into my main, I've got Baskin's lot number here. So I changed the heading by simply using a custom name set, and all that's done using the PI System Manager tools, batch custom names, and then applying those within ProcessBook.